I wrote this down because I should say later. Have you guys ever heard of there's no such thing as a free lunch? Pretty common in Seattle, certainly. But Tyler has it because he's staying at our house probably in Berlin. And every night at about midnight, when everybody's leaving, Abby and I would sit down after everybody leaves and we get the house cleaned up. Did you get money from such and such? Yes. And she always comes to me, did you get money from Tyler? Well, I thought you did. No, he didn't get money. So, Jordan, I gotta tell you, you're gonna get a really big bill in the mail. All this piece of money this guy owes us. Because it's astronomical. And Abby's actually started putting it in a spreadsheet. So, he's gonna as long as Tyler and I have been friends, which has been almost, I don't know, 15, 17 years, naturally, me being the best man at his wedding, you would think that he would have been the best man at my wedding, right?
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
No, that's not the case. He wasn't. He was asked. But he wasn't. But again, that falls under the girls' discussion, not my talk. And I said, oh, which I won't comment on. So he says, this girl I've been seeing, her name is Jordan. I said, okay, so she spells it with an I, so from then on out, her nickname is Jordan with an I. So he said, can I bring over this girl named Jordan? And I said, okay, Abby, how am I going to remember this? He says, I don't know, so I figured, hey, I'll follow Jordan. So she brings over, he brings over Jordan with an I, and we're sitting in the living room on the couch talking about normal things that you talk about when we first meet somebody. It's awkward conversation. And I'm sitting there on the floor, and I'm like, God, it smells like poop in here. I'm like, I'm not going to say somebody smells like poop. I'm going to have to change the diaper. So I'm like, I just let it go. And God bless her, left an everlasting impression on me. Dude. She picks up my Waterloo seat and smells her butt. And she goes, yep, it's her. I'm like, yeah, I didn't smell that. It's not like she just like held her out, right? She's like, oh yeah, it's her. It's her. Well, she went full nose to butt. You can tell she knew what she was doing. So I think I told her that night. I was like, I think you found your girl, buddy. You didn't get rid of this one. So we hung out many times. We went on vacation together. And I stand by that comment. I think you found your girl. So, of all the things I've told you to do in your life, it's probably the best one. Some of them were bad, some of them were really bad, but this is probably the best. Congratulations. To wrap this up, most people in this situation do a quote from somebody famous, whether it be John Lennon, Abraham Lincoln, JFK. I'm going to do a quote from the most influential male role model in my life, which is my grandfather. And every time he left my house or I left his house, he would hug me and he would say, Joshy, and I hated it when he called me Joshy. Joshy, you have one life to live, don't screw it up, and don't do anything I really do. So, if you want to stand up, buddy, just like my grandfather, I'm going to give you a big hug, buddy. And I'm going to tell you, you have one life to live. Don't screw it up, and don't do anything. Congratulations.